Hello everyone, Mitya here, and today I'm going to be reviewing the Sega Dreamcast set. So basically guys, let's take a look here. So as you can see right here, it says Dreamcast model number HTT30. As you can see right here, it's Sega Enterprises verified EMC. And right here it says risk of electric shock, do not open. But right here it also says shock hazard, do not open. Risk the choc electro ne pas uvar. Right here says Sega Enterprises Ltd HKT3030. So that blocks the cut is the barcode number for it. There's like three stands on each of these. Two of these are pads. Two of these are actually plastic on the back, and these two here are rubber. Maybe there used to be rubber, but fell off. Anyways, the screws on the Sega has actually been removed. Also back here is the serial, AC in, AV out, and the line ports. It's like a little stain right there. And then on the side here is actually an expansion port, which we will get to later. So anyways, let's first start. So basically, firstly, we're gonna click the open button, and right here is all the screws, as you can see. So here's all the screws. So firstly, what I actually want to do is I actually want to go move the screws, just in case. And then we can go and carefully slide off. Well, actually, just to get a good grip, let's go close up the disk drive. And now, after we've got that removed, now we can easily slide off the top cover. Just gotta do it very gently. And there we go. Cover's now slided off. See? And right here is actually this like little thing, as you can see. So basically, if we remove this, then whenever I click on the disc, if I remove this little piece here, if I remove this little thing here, so basically you can see, basically this actually prevents it from closing. So basically this is, so this is like the open button. See, the open button's supposed to expand like that. However, without this little thing, you can easily just pop open. Here's what it looks like from the bottom. See, so basically if you move that back, it is supposed to there we go. But however, without that, bang. Now it can no longer close it. So anyways, let's just go and reattach this. So first we're gonna go and take the loophole and thread it on that plastic piece, and then I'm gonna go and take the, oh god, I don't wanna lose it. So basically what we wanna do is reattach this here, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go stretch the cable onto that little loop. There we go. Now it works as usual. And then this is actually like the little light. So basically the light goes here, it travels down there, just holding my two screws. And the light comes out actually right here. So yeah. Anyways, let's actually get started by looking at the components. So firstly, what we want to do is we want to go disattach this piece here, which runs to the power button. This is our main source. Like that. And then we can slide this out of the way. Like so. Good. Next, you want to make sure that we have a barrier right here. Now, yes, you may be wondering, what is this plastic piece? This is actually a barrier, like I just said, like a second ago. And right here, you can actually see, like, these little things here. These, like, things here are 12 volts, so it can actually shock the components. So that's why there's a plastic barrier. Right here is the little thing, and then after this, like, little processor here, then we got the 3-6 volts pieces. But anyways, now all we gotta do is wiggle this out gently so nothing happens, because this Sega actually still works. So you wanna be careful, just like so. There we go. There. And now we can go and just take this and put it right there. Just like that. Good. So now that we got one component out, let's move it here. Just like that. Perfect. So now that we got that out of the way, if I go move this here, next up, and then we can remove the barrier. Here's the barrier. It's actually a bit bent, but whatever, maybe nothing will happen. There's a hole right there. Caution for continued safety, replace barrier after servicing. And then right here is our little cable, and oh no, the cable Yeah, that needs to be soldered back on. See, that needs to be soldered. Look at that. The thing needs to be soldered, though. Damn. Okay, we're not gonna touch the cable. We're just gonna go. Wait, I need to go tell my dad. Okay, sir, I actually told my dad if this is fixable, and he said yes. So, yeah, basically, yeah, this cable is just kinked. It's disconnected. Oh, it just fell off. See? There's the soldering points. Should be right around there. See, so that's what should be connected. It should be soldered like that, but as you can see, it's gone. So, yeah, whatever. My dad said it's fixable, so what does it matter? Anyways, next up is the controller port, and as you can see right here is this cable, which actually should connect down there, but I actually decided to leave that disconnected because it's actually always a pain, and I don't wanna like bend this cable here that much. This little thing, you actually see it's like a bit bent, and I don't wanna bend it any more than that, so that's why that's disconnected. Anyways, next we gotta go and disconnect this, so let's go pop this out of the controller ports. If we can, of course. Actually, I feel like it would be easier if we go and first remove the hard drive. So let's go and pop it out. There we go. Now the hard drive is removed, and that's where it goes in. And this piece here is actually also removed, so we can get to see what it looks like instead of a hard drive. So if I move this out of the way, that's what it looks like. Just bare minimum, and the motor is actually underneath here, so yeah. Slide that back in, and there we go. And we mustn't actually touch the lens, so I have to be careful, so yeah. So let's go put that right there. Good. And now what we want to do is we want to go, since we have enough room now, we can just go and slide out the controller port thingies here. However, they're actually clicking in place. Oh, there we go. Yeah. Now they're popped out. And there's also a little pigtail. There's also a little pigtail right here, which can actually be popped out. Oh, there we go. Look at that. That's easy. But anyways, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to go and reattach the pigtail back into place like so. There we go. There we go. Good. So basically, I can actually remove this, but I don't want to rip off these wires or the pigtail. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move this out of the way over here for now. And then next up, we got this. Here, piece here. We even got the little fan adapter. Look at that! It has actually been removed. How shocking! It has actually been removed. Look at that. So that's literally not like the only thing we have to remove. So now all we gotta do is we gotta go remove this base here, just like that, and then the whole entire thing can be removed. Here's the fan shroud, and as you can see, the fan shroud just slides in like so, just like that. Good. So there's the fan shroud. We can also remove that. And now next up we got the motherboard. Now, you may be wondering, come on, remove the motherboard. Well, actually, I can't. And the reason why is because of this expansion port. So let me just pop this out real quick. See, there's the expansion port. And if we go to the side of the console, it says extension. I don't know why I said expansion, but basically you just remove this. And then you attach an extension here to something else. So yeah, there's your little extension port. And that's actually what's holding in the motherboard in place. And which is the Sega 1999. So yeah, this is really old. However, before we remove this, let's go remove these four controller ports. Like that. And actually, I can actually show you how this works. Basically, the controller ports are here. And then this attaches onto the controller ports, just like so. And then the two screws go on top, I guess. See? So that's how this goes. So that's how your little four controller ports work. So that's very nice. So that's pretty nice right there. Anyways, now with that removed, now we can go and remove the bottom. Now we can go and remove the motherboard, just like so. With the motherboard removed, there's the underneath. So that's pretty nice. We don't want to damage this motherboard because, like I said, it still works. Here's that. Here is Sega. So that's pretty nice. So I can go remove this. And the final thing we got in here is this little thing. So first of all, we need to go and take these little pads and put them on top. Just like so. We even got this pad here, which actually got destroyed. So we're just going to go and turn it around like that and push it on in place. And the final thing we got is, once again, like I said, this little piece. And there we go. Bang. Everything's removed from the Sega, and the only thing that's left is the power button being held in at, with only these two screws. And there we go. See, now that's my entire Sega gutted out. And actually, this is actually pretty light. This plastic is actually pretty light, I must say. So, 13041. So, yeah. Anyways, if you excuse me, now we can just go and... now we can just go and put this all back in. So, with a little bit of editing just kidding. I'm not doing editing matters. I'll just be boring. I'm actually gonna go and put this back in case you guys don't... In case you guys don't want to damage anything. So, basically, just the opposite of taking it all apart. So, basically, first... The first thing we gotta do is we gotta go and take the bottom plate. We gotta go slide it in like so, being careful not to damage it. And slide it in like that. Make sure we push it in all the way. Make sure these pads are pressed down, just like that. Next, we can go and take the motherboard. Next, we can go and take the motherboard, which was actually made in Japan. That's very nice. Let's go and slide the motherboard back in. Good. Slide in the motherboard. Bam. Good. Now, actually, this is actually optional. You can actually do this without it being together or with it being together. I'm just going to do it without the Sega Dreamcast being fully built, and I'm going to go and reattach the expansion port. Good, and in fact, actually, you can actually see that's where the line port is on as well. It's on the extension port. Now with that in place, now the motherboard can no longer be removed because of that holding it in place. And also, these ports can actually, this is actually also pushed into the plastic at the back, so it can no longer be removed. Next up, the next thing we need to get put in is the little fan shroud. So you want to make sure you find the correct position for it. I feel like it was something like this. No, that's not correct. It's like that. There you go. So now let's go put the fan shroud back into place like that. And we can also go put back the controller ports. Just like so. Wait, we need to get it correct. So let's go put back the controller ports. There you go. And then we can go and take the metal piece which goes over it. And we can go and carefully slide it in. There you go. That wasn't actually so bad. And now the fan shroud is being held in place. Let's also go take the controller ports. There we go. And then we can go and slide it in. Actually, let's go and turn it. There we go. So now we can go and push the controller ports back in like so. Let's go pull this up. Push the controller ports in. There we go. Now that is clicked in place. That's very neat. There. So now that's clicked in. Anyways. Good. So now we can go and take the hard drive next. Just like so. So now I got the hard drive in place. Ooh, that's cold. And now we are going to go and take the hard drive. And we are going to go and push it on like that. Until it seats against the console. Good. So now we got the hard drive in place. The next thing we need to do is get the barrier in place, just like so. Bang. Let's also get our wire prepared, which has actually been, like, cut off, which is supposed to be right here. So let's go get the wire prepared and loop it over. Let's actually go and put it down here. And then we can go and take... Ouch! Okay, we don't want to destroy this. Now we want to go and take this. Good. Let's go and... Good. So let's go and slide this cable inside just like so before we seat it in all the way like that. Good. And then the last thing to do, reattach it on, and then we can seat it down all of the way. There. See? Now with that seated down, now with that set down all the way, as you can see. Actually, I'm pretty sure we can do a bit better than that. So we need to go remove this again. And now what we can do is we can just pop out of one side only, like that, and then put the cable down like that. Wait, I feel like it's not gonna work, or is it? There. There. Now, that is fully seated down, and as you can see, the cable runs to where it's supposed to go. That's clicked in. There we go. Now it looks normal. And now, the final thing, and now we can go and take the cover. pop open the disk drive for later, and then we can go and slide the cover back on just like so. Being careful not to damage it. We just need to align it real quick. There. There. Now that is clicked in, let's make sure we push it down firstly. That side's clicked in, that side's clicked in. There we go. Man, there's also a crack here, but oh well. Anyways, and the final thing we need to do is take the screws, and as you can see, they've actually been wrapped around in this bag. So we're just gonna do that again. Like so. We're just gonna put the screws back in, close it up, and there we go. See? Now the Sega is back, and now we can go put the Sega back in place. Now guys, do not worry. No, not worry. The Sega Dreamcast will still work even if it's like that, see? So let's go push it back all the way until it seats against the wall, and there we go. That's the end of the video. Yep. End of the video. So, goodbye guys. See you on the next one.